Hello and welcome to all in this video lectures series on 8051 microcontroller. We are discussing the simple timer section which is present in 8051 microcontroller. Till today we had a discussion on the different blocks associated with the timer section, that is timer 0 register, timer 1 register, TMOD register, TCON register, the bit configuration associated with the TMOD and TCON register, and the mode 1 of operation for timer. In today's lecture we are going to discuss the mode 2 operation, okay, that is a timer programming in mode 2. So let's begin. So as we know that when we talk about this timer 0 or timer 1, okay, right, both these registers are 16 bit wide, and to select proper mode of operation here the TMOD register is used, right? And the TMOD register is basically an 8 bit wide register, right? So today we are going to discuss this, that is a 8 bit auto reload mode for timer. Now what is this 8 bit auto reload mode? As its name indicate, basically it is mode 2 of operation and selected when M1 bit is 1 and M0 bit is 0 from TMOD register. And as its name suggests, right, it is an 8 bit auto reload, means whatever the 16 bits are there, out of these 16 bits only lower 8 bits are used for the operation. And hence, as only 8 bits are used, the minimum value is 00H and the maximum value that can be reached during the operation is a FFH here. And after FFH, right, then the rollover occurs. Right. So this is about what the concept of this 8 bit. Now what is the concept of auto reload? Right. In case of this auto reload, whatever the count value is there, right, the count value basically we are going to copy into higher 8 bits of selected timer. If I am using timer 0, then whatever the count value is there, this count value is loaded into higher 8 bits of timer 0. And if we are using timer 1, then this 8 bit value is loaded into the higher 8 bits of timer 1. And the moment at which we turn on the timer, right, automatically the value present in this higher 8 bits, okay, so this value is get automatically loaded into lower 8 bits. Okay, so here the value present in TH0 is copied into TL0 when the timer 0 is selected, and the value present in TH1 is loaded into TL1 when timer 1 is selected, right? So what will happen? The moment at which we turn on the timer, the initial count value, suppose my initial count value is X, it is get automatically loaded into lower 8. And this value is now goes on incrementing by 1 depending upon the reception of clock pulse, whereas the contents of this higher 8 bits remains as it is, right? So in this way, right, at one moment it is going to reach the final permissible limit, that is FFH, and then the rollover occurs. And the moment at which the rollover occurs, again whatever the value which is present in higher 8 bits of timer is again get reloaded, automatically reloaded into lower 8 bits here, right? Means from X up to FF, right, and then the rollover, and again this X is loaded, right? So this present in THN register, that is the higher 8 bits of selected timer, this is get copied into lower 8 bits of selected timer, goes on incrementing up to FF, then the rollover, and once the rollover is occur, again the value is get loaded into this TI. Manually or by using any instruction, it is not necessary to reload the value, and that's why this concept is called as a auto reload. So let us now discuss the programming steps for this, and before that, as usual, let's discuss how to find out the count value for mode, right? So here for the discussion we are going to consider the external crystal of value 11.0592 megahertz, and first step that we have to do is what, right, divide the given delay by 1.085 microsecond, right, and whatever the obtained result is there, now this result we are going to term as a M, fine. Then subtract the value obtained in step 1 from 256, because as we are dealing with the 8-bit mode, we are utilizing 8-bit right from 0 up to 255. Total the count that we are going to consider is a 256, right? So the result that is obtained in step number 1, we are going to subtract it from 256, that is xx is equal to 256 minus n, right? And now this obtained result is there into decimal number format. So in step 3, convert this decimal number, that is the result obtained in step number 2, into hex format, right? So I am going to term this xx as mm, that is mm represents the hex equivalent of obtained result, which was there earlier into decimal format. And once we do it, simple, load this hex value into the higher 8 bits of selected time. So these are the steps that we have to follow when we are using the 8-bit auto reload mode, right? So it is 8-bit auto reload mode for timer in 8051 microcontroller. Okay, so let us consider one simple example. Calculate the count value to be loaded in timer 0, generate the delay of 10 microseconds, right? And for this, suppose I am going to we are discussing the mode 2, we are going to consider here as what? Simple 8-bit auto reload mode. Okay, right? So first of all, in this program statement or in this provided statement, the delay value is given. And what is the delay value? The delay value is a 10 microsecond. So in step 1, what we have to do? Whatever the amount of given delay is there, this delay we have to divide by 1.085 microsecond, right? So because of that, say 10 microsecond divided by 1.085 microsecond, so the obtained result is 9.20. So approximately I am going to consider the count value as a 9, right? Because the fractional value we can't load into the register, and that's why I am going to consider here the subtraction result, the division result as a 9. Then the next step, subtract value obtained in step 1, that is here the n, that the nomenclature we have used, right, from 256. Okay, so simple, 9. So the obtained result is what? 247. This is there into decimal format. Okay, it is there into decimal number format. So convert this obtained result in step number 2 into hex value, right? So once we convert this 247 into hex, the obtained result is what? F7H, right? So this is the value, and this value finally we have to load into the higher 8 bits of required timer. And as we are using the timer 0 here, right, so we are going to load this F7H into the higher 8 bits of timer 0, right? So in this way, the count value calculation is done for mode 2 in 8051 microcontroller, right? So let us consider one simple program statement. Assume that the crystal of 11.0592 megahertz is connected to 8051 microcontroller. Write a program to generate a square wave of 5 kilohertz on pin P2.5, right? So we are supposed to use the timer 0 in mode 2. So as usual, first of all, we have to calculate the amount of the count value that need to be loaded into the higher 8 bits. Okay, so here we are using the timer 0, so this should be TH0. So the first step is what? Just divide the given delay by 1.085 microsecond. So first of all, we have to calculate the amount of delay. Here the frequency provided, the F value is what? It's a 5 kilohertz, right? So the total time period here is 1 upon F, and that is 200 microsecond. Right, so the total time period T is equal to T on plus T off in our case. Why? Because as only square wave is mentioned, we have to consider the 50% duty cycle, right? So hence the T on is equal to T off, right? And because of that, the amount of delay means we have to keep the status of pin P2.5 high for this much portion, which is exactly half of this total time period, right? And hence this given, that is the total time period, we have to divide by 2, and this 100 microsecond we are going to consider as what? The required amount of delay, right? So this is 100 microsecond, right? So Now the amount of delay that we got is what? Simple 100 microsecond. Okay, so the first step, just divide the given delay by 1.085 microsecond. So when we divide it, that is 100 microsecond divided by 1.085 microsecond, right? So the value that I'm getting is what? 92. So in next step, we have to subtract this 256, this obtained value, that is 92. Just consider this as only 8 bit number. So that is what the XX value, and here the result that I'm going to get is suppose MM. Right, okay. So just subtract this to this obtained result, that is value of n, from 256. So 256 minus 92, so the obtained result is a 165, right? And this is there again into decimal format. So simple, convert this decimal into hex. So when we convert the decimal value, 164 into hex, we get the A4H here. Okay, so this A4H we are going to load into the higher 8 bits of timer series. So in this way, first we have calculated the count value, and this count value need to be loaded into the TH0. Okay. So now just see this program, just originate here, right? Then H jump to main. Now move timer comma hash 0 to H. So what will happen? Simple gate C slash T bar M1 M0, again gate C slash T bar M1 and M0. Right. So these are the total 8 bits which are there with us, right? And as we are not using the timer 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 for timer 1, and for timer 0, we have to select the mode 2. So for mode 2, it is a 1, 0. So this value is a 2 and this value is a 0. So the equivalent value that need to be loaded into TMOD register is what? 0 to H, right? So this 0 to H, I am going to copy into TMOD register. Now the A4H, it is what? It is our calculated value, right? So in order to get the what we call the frequency of 5 kilohertz on this P2.5, whatever the amount of count that is required, so that is A4. So this A4 is loaded into the higher 8 bits of timer 0. Now simple set P2.5, so I am going to set this P2.5 here, right? So here it is initially with a high level. So just call delay. So in this delay, I am going to turn on the timer. So the moment at which I am going to turn on the timer, initially TH0 is going to hold A4H. The same values get loaded into TL0. So now the TL0 is going to hold A4H here. Okay. And depending upon the clock pulse, let me rewrite it properly. Right. So now TL0 is equal to A4H. Right. So when the first clock pulse is received here, okay, so for that the values get incremented by 1. So A5, for next A6. In this way the value is going to reach up to FFH. So whatever the amount that required for the timer, right? So the time span, this time span is practically equal to what? 100 microsecond. Ideally equal to 100 microsecond. Right. So what will happen? Right. For this much amount of time, the status of P2.5 remains at a high level. Right. So here for what? 100 microseconds. So at this moment, the value present in this what we call the timer 0 higher 8 bit is A4. Right. And when it is reaches at this point, it is now FFH. Right. So here. And once it is reached to FFH, the rollover occurs and this value, whatever present automatically, that is A4 value, automatically get loaded into TL0, right? So here for the rollover, the TF0 flag is going to change its status. It is going to change from 0 to 1, right? And for this much amount of time, the TF0 is equal to 0, right? So what will happen here? Just start the timer and wait for TF0 to set. So until it is low, just we are going to wait for the execution. So here the TF0, JNB TF0 to back. As the status of TF0 is 0, it is going to jump to this back level, means into the same row, right? And the moment at which this rollover occurs, the status is going to change from 0 to 1. As it is a 1, just stop the timer and just clear the timer flag. What will happen here? Simple. The status of P2.5 is changed from high to low, right? And then this S jump to loop, right? So loop means what? Here again call the delay. So again inside this delay routine, set bit TR1, so the timer start, here the value is A4 and it is reaching up to FFH. So in this way, the mode 2 of operation is done for timer to generate the required frequency. So in this way, basically the things are working for mode 2. Okay. Now the one thing is clear: when we compare this mode 1 operation with that of mode 2, right? When the rollover occurs, whatever the initial value is there, this initial value with the help of instructions we have to load again into timer. But in this case, automatically the values are get loaded into the TL0. So let us cross check this with some execution, right? So this is our program. I'm going to build it. Simple. Here the timer 0 is configured into mode 2. Then just load this A4 value, that is a count value, then set P2.5, call delay clear P2.5, right? And the moment at which I am going to run this code, okay, so let me select the port pin P2. Yeah, P2 is there with us. In setup I am going to select and I am now going to run. So the moment at which I am going to run the code, right, here the P2.5, so the P2.5, the square wave is generated. Now the interesting fact here, now let us check out this. The initial count value, the timer 0 is there into mode 2, that is 8 bit auto reload, and TCON is loaded with, TH0 is loaded with the A4, and now the value is a DC, right? So just pay attention here, how the things are going to work. Now the TF is not set. As the TF is not set, when I am dealing with a stepwise execution, the value present in TL0 is continuously goes on incrementing, and still we are waiting to the same statement here, right? And the P2.5 is still at low level. So the moment at which, right, now it is a FE, for next the rollover occurs. So the moment at which the rollover occurs, the TF0 is get set, and the value which is present in TH0 is get automatically loaded into TL0. And the next increment will start from this TL0 itself, whereas the TH0 contain remains as it is. Right? So that's why it is called as a 8-bit auto reload.